categorize the schools. We have government schools which are almost free of cost but low quality education centers, and we have private schools which are high quality but extremely high cost education ventures. People find themselves in a dilemma. They cannot send, especially people in the lower income bracket. They don't want to send their school. They don't want to send their children to the free of charge government schools because they know that the quality of education is really poor. But at the same time, they cannot afford the high end private schools. This is where low cost education, low cost private education comes into the picture. It bridges this gap. Moving on to the idea explanation. These enterprises are basically low profit and high risk enterprises. This is why we believe that government backing is extremely important for their existence. Government should basically collaborate with these institutions so that they are recognized, so that children, when they pass out from these institutes, they have a fighting chance to compete for higher education along with other students from private colleges or other, the better run government colleges, the government schools. The people who are going to carry forward this idea are known as edupreneurs, which is educators and entrepreneurs. They have a twin role of providing quality education to the students as well as making a profit. Let me tell you something. This is a profit-making venture. We are not providing charity here. These are extremely profitable businesses. They are extremely profitable ventures. But what is essential for their survival is government collaboration. In terms of investment, in terms of being recognized, in terms of providing free land, so that the initial cost of setting up these institutes does not overshoot the limit, because like I mentioned, these are no-profit ventures. A proliferation of these institutes will ensure that these are recognized, these are accepted by the people, and they're basically there's a knowledge of